As gemstone miners in Zambia, and particularly this time I want to talk about the emerald sector, but also I would speak about other sectors in across the country where we mine gemstones. We are worried at the levels at which we are ignored as a sector, because as a sector we are also voters and we have electorate in all the regions. In Lufanyama itself, where I come from in the emerald area, the Mukumbo ward, which hosts the emerald mining area, consists of 1,800 plus voters, close to 2,000 voters that are in that area. And yet we've been calling for empowerment of the youth, who are the majority in that area, all registered voters. We've been calling for empowerment, but yet all comes to no fruition, that no one responds to us, no one is willing to meet us, and we have mines of over 400 mine owners, most of them that are stuck, and they host each one of us as a maximum or minimum of 10 workers that we have kept at our mines. We've stopped paying them because we have no resources. We've been lobbying for equipment, we've been lobbying for diesel, even to just pump out water that we could be doing a pick and shovel, but nothing comes to fruition. We want to call upon the government that, can you please for once consider meeting the small scale miners in all the areas, but at particular time I'm calling on the government to meet us as small scale miners in Lufanyama. Consider empowering us that you've been empowering other sectors of the economy. If the musicians can be empowered, if the youths that are just loitering in town can be empowered, what is wrong with us? What wrong have we done as emerald miners and our so-called artisanal small-scale miners that are scavenging over the dumps in Lufanyama? Mufurila has been given, Chingola has been given the dams. Kitwe, they are yet to be given even the Black Mountain. Luansha has been given. But yet we've been advocating that we meet the government so that we discuss the way forward on how we can empower the youths in Lufanyama as well in terms of the dams. If not the dams, we have ideas that we can give forth. There is a mine there called Kamakanga, which has been lying idle for a very long time. And when people go there to try and dig there, they are chased as illegals. Where are we chasing them to? Because as much as we chase them, they'll come back into town and they'll start stealing. They feel left out. They feel neglected. We also feel neglected as mine owners. There are over 400 emerald miners. We feel neglected. We have ideas, but no one wants to hear to our ideas.